Hi, Michelle Glass here, and our topic for today is the frontal and the parietal bones. And notice with my skull, I've taken off the mandible because it doesn't stay attached and it gets in my way, so I'm going to put that to the side. To begin, notice I have my model looking the same direction as myself so that it shows up on the screen here. As a student, you should of course be facing the model so you're eye to eye with the skull there. To begin, we're looking at the frontal bone, which is this bone here. And you do want to practice tracing out for yourself that whole bone. So you want to use your suture lines. Mine are nice and colored in. My hand got in the way there. Notice the frontal bone is making up some of the eye orbit or eye socket there. So include that as well. So all of this is the frontal bone. Next thing I want to do is take my fingers across the top of this eye orbit here, and this is called my supraorbital margin. The term supra means above the orbit, supraorbital, and then the term margin or crest can be used for these edges in the bone, and so that's what we're looking at here, and you can feel that. If you take your finger in medially toward the nose, you'll feel there's a little notch here. Let me see if I can, there you go. That notch is called the supraorbital notch. On some models, it's a complete circle, which would be called a foramen. So you might see that in some of your diagrams. We are labeling the notch. Take your fingers from the notch, bring them out laterally, and then up inside the eye orbit. And you should feel a little depression there. Depression in a bone is called a fossa. That singular fossa with an AE ending as plural. These depressions are called the lacrimal fossae. You have a little tear gland up here above the eyeball called the lacrimal gland, and so the fossa is making room for that. The final thing to name on our structure sheet is this flattened part of the frontal bone, which is called the frontal squama. Remember, we had the term squamous for our epithelial tissues, which meant flat. And so here we have the flattened part of the frontal bone. So the whole thing, again, we're gonna look for our frontal bone, use your suture lines to trace that for yourself. Take your fingers across the supraorbital margin, bring them in medially for the supraorbital notch, bring them up to the inside lateral part of the eye orbit for the lacrimal fossa, and then find the frontal squama. The next bones we're gonna label are the parietal bones, and we are simply naming these. We are naming the right and the left parietal bone. Because my model is facing the same direction as myself, my right and the model's right are the same. If it was, if I was looking eye to eye with my model, remember my right would be the model's left. So make sure when you're doing left and right that you're doing that based on your subject or your model. Again, with your parietal bones, go ahead and trace out for yourself using those suture lines so you see what is the parietal bone. And you can do that on both sides. Oops, there you go.